Hello students, welcome to Marine Engineering Tutorials. I am Atul Kumar Gupta and back with a new tutorial. We are presently studying marine boilers. Today we have 6th lecture and the topic is Scotch boilers. Scotch boiler is one of the earliest boiler used on steamships. Being a low pressure boiler, it was used for auxiliary purposes. Early boilers had riveted construction, but later boilers were fabricated by welding. It is a tank type boiler with horizontal design. As horizontal designs consume more space, it is not preferred on the motor vessel nowadays. In the following slides, we will learn its constructional details and the flow of gases through the boiler. The figure shows a Scotch boiler with single furnace, although other design had two or three furnaces depending on boiler size and required evaporation rate. So we can see this is the furnace and it is extended into the combustion chamber, and these are the smoke tubes which are bringing the flue gases back to the front end, and they are taking the third pass through these tubes on the side of the combustion chamber, and they take it back to the other end from where it is exhausted. The main rubber plating is usually in two parts joined by double wet welding, which forms the main pressure part. So that is the main drum. Boiler is mounted on its foundation with four anti-rolling stays. You can see here, of which two front ends are fixed, whereas other two are the sliding type to provide free expansion of the boiler, thereby avoiding undue distortion. The furnaces of suspension bulb type, corrugated for strength, which also provides increased surface area. Furnaces extended by a large combustion chamber made up of thin plates, which return the flue gases to the front end by attached plane and stay tubes. Combustion chamber is supported by means of stays, girders and tubes. So we can see this is the combustion chamber and these are the longitudinal stays by which it is attached, supported, and the stay tubes, they also support it with the front plate. Plain tubes and stay tubes are in the ratio of 3:1. These tubes carry flue gases from the combustion chamber to the boiler uptake and support boiler front tube and combustion chamber front plate. Two manhole openings are usually provided. We can see one of the manhole is on the rubber plating and other on the rear side of the boiler tube plate. These openings are compensated to restore the plate strength, and the manholes on the rubber plating should have minor axis parallel to the boiler axis. Gauge glasses are mounted on the front tube plate, which we can see here. And its bottom connection is minimum 5 inches above the top of the combustion chamber. We can compare from here. So the gauge glass is above the top, and the crown of the combustion chamber is fitted with a fusible plug to prevent the damage to the tubes due to shortage of water. Combustion chamber crown is thus having a fusible plug. Internal feed pipe is closed at the ends and is perforated throughout its length to distribute relatively cold feed water over large space to avoid local cooling of the hot boiler plate and tubes. So the feed water is supplied through feed and check valve. Inside there is a internal pipe which is having perforation so that the cold water is distributed along the length of the boiler. Important boiler mountings are shown at the respective places, which include safety valve. Then we have mainstream stop valve, air vent. We have the feed and check valve. We have manhole, and we have blowdown valve. And the fusible plug is another mounting, which is equipped in all type of boilers. In the modern boilers, instead of fusible plug, there is low water level trip device, which is a better arrangement as compared to fusible plug. In the subsequent slide, we will see a package type of boiler which is usually provided on the ships. We can see in the sketch that there is a package arrangement for this Scotch boiler. That means the boiler along with its auxiliary machinery and associated components are all mounted on the common base plate. So we can see the feed pump, we can see the control panel, we can see the force draft fan and the other mountings are shown over here. These boilers are usually available in a package form with all associated equipment mounted on a common platform as shown in the sketch. To relieve the internal pressure, boiler is equipped with improved high lift safety valve with easing gear arrangement. Boiler blowdown valve used to be earlier a non-return valve to prevent the entry of seawater, as earlier boilers were installed on the bottom platform in the engine room, which was below the load water line. Whereas the boilers nowadays are installed above the water line to prevent the backflow, blowdown valve is connected with an internal pipe to completely empty out the boiler when required. This boiler was heavily constructed and had a durable design. For ease of inspection and maintenance, front and rear smoke doors were davited, which are shown over here. It required very low maintenance. The boiler was usually operated at 10.5 bar with efficiency of 81%, although it had maximum working pressure up to 20 bar. So this is a brief description of the Scotch boiler. We will discuss other smoke tube boiler in the next tutorial. This book is written by me and covers all the topics as per syllabus of Indian Maritime University. It clarifies the concept with simple illustrations. This book also provides answers to all the questions which have appeared in the examination conducted by Indian Maritime University. This book can help the students in preparing for the exam and also to work on the ship's boilers safely. Hope you have liked the lecture. You can write your feedback in the comment box. If you have liked the tutorial, you may share it with your friends. You may subscribe to the channel for getting notification about the new tutorials. I'll be back with a new lecture shortly. Thanks for watching the tutorial till the end.